Oikein hyvää päivää. Tervetuloa uuden videon pariin. Mä ajattelin tässä välissä tehdä pientä vähän niin kuin Max Payneä tässä tuon Resident Evilin sijaan. Sitä tulee kyllä taas kyllä varmaan aika paljon sinne, mutta mä ajattelin tähän väliin tehdä vähän jotain muuta, niin mä oon pelannut tätä Max Payneä kyllä ennen. Ennen kanssa niitä ykköstä ja kakkosta, eli ykkösessä tämä toimi niin kuin poliisina, en tiedä muista, toimiko se tässä kolmosessa. Joku anyway-runkkari se oli tässä. Mä vittu eilen yritin tätä videoa tehdä vittu monta kertaa, mutta jostain syystä meni aina pieleen se, niin sen takia mä oon vähän vituttaa tää, että mä teen tätä vittu kuudennetta kertaa tätä samaa paskaa. Niin, katsotaan näin. You're right. I think I am gonna like it here. It certainly ain't New Jersey. It's my new life, just like you said. Eli ykkösessä siellä kuoli vaimo ja lapset. Kakkosesta nyt en juuri muista mitään. What have I got to lose? Apart from the weight. Very funny. Ha, ha. Tässä on hyvä tarina, yes, hyvä ääninäyttelijä. Hienosti tehty ampumiskohtaukset. Ei tarvi erikseen editoida videoihin hidastuksia, kun tässä on omasta takaa. Mutta katsotaan tämä näytös tästä.
So I guess I'd become what they wanted me to be. A killer. Some rent-a-clown with a gun who puts holes in other bad guys. Well, that's what they had paid for, so in the end, that's what they got. Say what you want about Americans, but we understand capitalism. You buy yourself a product and you get what you pay for. And these chumps had paid for some angry gringo without the sensibilities to know right from wrong. Here I was, about to execute this poor bastard like some dime store angel of death. And I realized they were correct. I wouldn't know right from wrong if one of them was helping the poor and the other was banging my sister.
Tulee mieleen vähän GTA tästä.
I'd arrived in Sao Paulo a few weeks before. I was working a protection detail for the kind of people who need protection in a town like this. And what kind of town was this? One where I didn't speak the language and they didn't water down their drinks. So for now, we seemed to get along just fine. Of course, that was about to change.
Hey, brother.
Hey.
How's the cocktail?
Scotch. I never mix my drinks.
Yeah, at least not on duty.
Something like that.
Man, that favela is big.
Yep. Nothing like the view of extreme poverty to make a penthouse cocktail party really swing.
I guess they call it trickle-down economics.
That's funny.
It's supposed to be a charity thing. Drink and give money. I don't know. Something for the kids. Hey, listen, man. We better look lively. This place is a nightmare. You just got cowboys running security downstairs. Something rotten in the air.
That didn't mean much. There was always something rotten in the air. The family we were protecting were local celebrities, rich parasites with delusions of humanity. The kind of people who end up in glossy magazines or body bags, depending on how their luck runs.
So where are they all? I see Rodrigo over there talking to that guy.
Yeah, I don't know him. That guy next to him, he's some kind of cop. I'm not sure. Serious though, big end cop, anti-gang sort of thing. I can't remember his name.
Who's this guy?
That guy's a plastic surgeon or some kind of surgeon. Tummy tucks and cock implants. Look at Marcel. Still dances like a fool.
Guess that's what a European education and a coke habit will do for Ricky Martin look alike.
That's very funny, Max. Oh, excuse me.
I was mostly working for Rodrigo Branco, a local businessman. Built things, did some charity, had things named after him, won awards, owned things, people. One of the trophies he had won was his wife, Fabiana. She was hot and wanted to be dangerous. Some good genes trying to fight their way out of a cesspit. She'd married well and was now at leisure to regret her good fortune. They got along as well as any rich workaholic and his younger airhead wife tend to get along. They mostly ignored each other. She spent a lot of time with his cokehead younger brother, Marcello. He was a good time guy if your idea of a good time was an expensive suit, a bottle of champagne, and nothing between the ears. The middle brother, Victor, had just walked in. He was a local politician. Guy was smoother than an oil slick on an iceberg and about as toxic. The rest of the crowd, I didn't know, but I could imagine the types. People who know if they drink enough, they won't have to feel guilty about their good fortune. Suddenly, things turned real ugly. Felt like our hangovers arrived right on cue.
No niin, päästäänköhän me nyt aloittamaan tässä.
Things had gone from fine to fucked up in about a second, and now there were two idiots at the wheel.
Clear!
Kai se vissiin tässäkin joku poliisi, tai vai onko se joku...
It wasn't my own safety I was concerned about.
Tässä se on varmaan joku
bodyguard. Trophy wife or not. I'd said I would protect the girl.
That's
the boss lady.
Only this time she wasn't. Mä en vittu ymmärrä, satana. Mä oon kalibroinut tän niinku tähän vitun tietokoneen, silti tuolla noin Xbox-nappulat, satana. Miten vitusta on näin kovalla?
Vodka in her Cosmo.
Tulee ainakin hyvin tutuksi tää sama kenttä tässä. Vittu mua oikeesti, vittu sapettaa saatana.
Or maybe both. But before I knew it, I was back taking insane risks, trying to save fallen women.
Ja sit kun ei ymmärrä, mikä asetus siellä on välillä tuolta vitu OP:ssa, sit joku vittu pois päältä saa.
Tranquila! Tranquila! Nós cuidamos disso.
Nice work. Hey, you need a hand?
No, you? Where the hell's Rodrigo?
I don't know, man.
Ei sille, ettei kyllästy tästä samaa kentän, niin ei mua niinku kyllästy tätä samaa kentän pelaa, mutta mua vituttaa tää kuvaaminen tässä. Jos on tapahtunut vaikka sinne pelissä jotain, niinku semmoista tosi niinku joku hyvä juttu, niin et sä sitä voi enää uudestaan tässä sitten tuota jotain.
I imagine the elevator door is opening to a firing squad of muzzles. Far as I could see it, the one thing
helvetistä on näin kovalla tässä, no one else would be stupid enough to pull this move. Mahdollisimman nopeasti, mutta Y:tä pitää painaa, vittu. No ehkä mä otan ton tosta.
It looked like they were taking him out through the basement. Maybe I still had a shot. Rodrigo was too rich a prize for them to throw away. Sure, I'd have to work hard to get him back, but I knew the bad guys would want the boss alive almost as much as I did. Once I opened the door, I'd actually have to come up with a plan. The great thing about being famous as well as rich is the bad guys know who to kidnap. Another parking lot rattling with gunfire. Was I too late?
Continue a tirar on him.
Persa breaka. Vittu tää on kovalla, ei jumalauta. Miks tää on näin kovalla?
Rodrigo! I'm here!
Mene vittu kotiin siitä.
Rodrigo! It's Max!
Pahoittelen, että olen kiroillut niin paljon tässä. No voi vittu! Nyt tietenkin ääni rupeaa särisemään sitten.
Okay.
Okay. Saatana, kun mä siirsin tuota mikkiä. Sehän nähdään sitten.
It's okay.
Vocês aí, que porra vocês estão fazendo? A justiça local?
Que porra você acha que é, falando com meus homens assim?
Você acha que tem o direito de matar as pessoas a sangue frio, Becker?
Cala a boca, cuzão! Continua dando multas. Não põe o nariz onde não é chamado.
Mä tiedän, kannattaako sitä tässä vittu julkaista YouTubeen. Mä oikeesti niin vittu ärsyttää tää, kun mä oon miljoona kertaa tehnyt tää samaa ja kuvannut.
Fuck.
Olisi kiva päästä niinku tekemään vähän niinku muitakin kenttiä tästä kuin näitä tätä samaa.
Say so. Don't look so good.
Hey, what could be better, huh? The good guys are reunited and the Commando Sombra are dead.
I guess. So who's this guy?
I don't know.
Mä tosiaan eilen tätä pelasin.
Different branch of the police, not UFE, but normal cops. I don't know about this stuff.
Varmaan 5-6 kertaa peräkkäin ja vittu oli koko ajan jotain ongelmia.
Shit, you're kinda beat up. Let's get this lot home and then I'll get you home too. Come on.
Saa nähdä mitä nyt tulee sitten. Vai päästäänkö tänään ihan tällä ekalla kerralla?
Back home, it was time for some R&R, the only way I knew how. I was ready for bed.